You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Dr. Dre. Many different things spark a person's mind when that name is said. Some think music, others think headphones, and some think producer. All of these are correct, but one thing is not often said. A revolutionary. In this video, we are going to see how the downfalls and uprisings have made this man a success.
This one, getting it right. We're gonna create the best rap album ever made.
Andre Rommel Young was born on February 18th, 1965 to Theodore and Verena Young. Young's middle name, Rommel, was named after his father's R&B group, the Rommels. Born in Compton, California, Young was brought up in a culture that was heavily gang-affiliated. Young attended high school at Centennial High, but was later moved to Fremont High due to bad grades. Tired of school at this point, Young paid more attention to his social life and entertainment for the rest of high school. One of these types of entertainment was to go and see DJs and rappers live at a club called the Eve After Dark. Young was very inspired to be one of these and eventually started to DJ at the club. Young later coined himself as Dr. Dre. His origins came from his favorite basketball player, Julius Dr. J. Irving, and part of Young's first name. It was there where he also met DJ Yella, soon to be an NWA member. Together, both would join Dre's first group, the World Class Wrecking Crew.
Wherever you be, calling Dr. Dre to surgery.
The World Class Wrecking Crew was the intro to Dre's career. Despite the way they dressed at the time, World Class Wrecking Crew had been a hit in the West Coast, selling over 50,000 records in the Compton area. It was here where Dre also got a feel for more in-depth beats and production. Even though the Wrecking Crew gained popularity, Dre felt he could accomplish more. It was not until 1986 when Dre would evidently change the way we see hip-hop forever. Shortly after the breakup of World Class Wrecking Crew, Dre had already been productive, collaborating with O'Shea Jackson, better known as Ice Cube. Both had been making songs under the label Ruthless Records that had been owned by Eazy-E. E, impressed with the work that was coming from Dre, had decided to start a group that would consist of him, Ice Cube, MC Ren, DJ Yella, and Dr. Dre. They would then call themselves NWA and begin making records. NWA had developed a style that really no rappers at the time had done. Talk about controversial things. NWA's content would contain provocative lyrics as well as explaining an ideal gang life. Their first album, Straight Outta Compton, was one of the very first albums to ever get a parental advisory brand on the front. Dre was a pioneer of the new trend he had made titled G-Funk by the crowd. G-Funk is a mix between a funky type of beat mixed with gangster type lyrics and attitude. Despite the controversy, Straight Outta Compton had been a commercial success. As far as production, Dre was the head producer to most of the tracks. Critics at the time would describe the beats as ahead of its time and gave Dre a lot of credit due to all the new content and producing he had made with minimal funding. The group would later go on to make two other albums before Dre had disbanded from the group in 1991 due to financial problems involving Eazy-E. After leaving, Dre and bodyguard Suge Knight would go on to make their own production company, Death Row Records. Death Row Records was a joint duo pair of CEO Suge Knight and Dr. Dre as executive producer. In the process of getting the label up, Dre would then sign on hip-hop rapper Snoop Dogg. Snoop would later co-star in Dre's debut album, The Chronic. The album had received many praise and critics say added to the G-Funk style that he had pioneered. The production was quoted original because it had only used two samples and the rest was all made by Dr. Dre. Dre would later go on to produce solo albums by Snoop Dogg until he changed gears and signed hip-hop icon Tupac Shakur. Dre had seen much talent in Tupac and wanted him to be the star of Death Row Records. Tupac would then rise above the ranks with Dre producing and gaining more reputation, but history does repeat. Dre would then sign off Death Row Records, calling their CEO Suge Knight financially corrupted and unstable. Leaving Death Row with tons of new experience and connections, Dre
Dre decided to open up his own production company and call it Aftermath Entertainment. With it being Dre's own production company and all of his old partners contracted with Death Row, Dre was at a slight disadvantage. It went even more downhill when his label had been sued by an underground rock group of the same name. Rumors were circulating that Aftermath was facing huge financial struggle and was really in need for that one star to spark it up. But who would it be? Eminem, also known as Slim Shady, would be that spark. Eminem's style would be very controversial, and his lyrics would be spot on with Dre's style of beats. The two would collab, with Dre having vocals as well as Eminem. Dre would then go on to release his album, The Chronic 2001, having cameos with Eminem. The album was a sextuple in sales, and it had messages in there pertaining to how Dre is done with gangster rap and is moving on, focusing more on production. Currently, Aftermath Entertainment is still in the game as far as production. Commercial successes such as Eminem, 50 Cent, and Kendrick Lamar are still being produced by Dr. Dre and keeping the label alive. In July 2008, Dre yet again revolutionized music by releasing his Beats by Dre headphones. These headphones come in four different categories and are very high quality. Dre wanted listeners to actually hear all the nicks and knacks that went on during the song that you could not hear with a normal pair of headphones. Arguably for style or actual quality, these headphones are widely used in professional music studios and in the general public. There have even been instances where famous artists have been seen wearing these. Beats itself is starting to branch off and being speakers on HP laptops to even vehicles starting to have built-in Beats speakers. Dre does have future plans on releasing two new albums titled Detox and The Planets sometime in the future. Overall, Dre has come from a huge leap from being an in-club DJ to a CEO and entrepreneur to doing the thing he loves most, music. This is why Andre Rommel Young is a revolutionary.